What up, everybody? This is Stuart Knight, author of the books Marginalizing White Supremacy, Poetic Visions, A Steep Metaphor System, and my latest work, The Spirit the World Has Forgotten. And today I want to talk about why the ADOS concept has so broadly outpaced the Pan-Africanist concept that has been going on for 100 years, as far as Pan-Africanism is concerned. See, the reason why is because ADOS signifies a specific name for a specific group of people who suffered the indignations of a specific system that worked toward our degradation. Most of us understand that being chattel slavery. Now, whether you say enslaved or slavery, the object is that the concept and the outcome is still the same. Black people in this country were specifically harmed by that institution, which was slavery. Now, the naming aspect is very important when it comes to white supremacy, because naming gives relevance to an object under westernized culture. You see, the Greeks came about with the concept that if you name an object, you thus own that object. That is why, you know, during slavery, one of the first things that the slave master would do was take away the original name of that African slave and give them a name of their own. You know, so that way they signify their dominance over that object. Now, compare that to the African sense of philosophy, where things were not named until their essence was understood. In other words, you know, what that specific object did or put forth, you know, as far as its personality, whether it be human beings or rocks or trees, it was not giving a name until it was first understood what it did, and then it was named accordingly. That is why in African cultures there are naming ceremonies for children, which only come about once the personality of that child has been put forth or has been shown, so that way the name tied to that child actually specifies what that child's destiny would be. So in order for us, and that's something that Pan-Africanism just did not do, you see, because in Pan-Africanism, under the Pan-Africanist concept, which is definitely a just concept, we should understand and know our full history as a people, and we should fight oppression as a collective, which is very true, but you don't necessarily focus on that. It's best to understand the essence of why that oppression has occurred at the hands of white supremacists. And that is one part that, you know, most Pan-Africans fell short in going forth with the struggle against the white oppressive system, or as I would say it, white supremacy, the psychopathology of white supremacy. So naming is very important. And that is why, you know, this current society has finally started listening to the call for reparations, because a name has been tied to the specific people which suffered up under, which is very important in moving forth the narrative. Now, it's best at this point that each and every black person who can be considered themselves ADOS really learn, understand their history, understand what types of harmful damage was done to the black person under slavery, or the enslaved black person, so as you know that you can see some of the ill behaviors and ill traits that we still carry forth to this day from that system. And one of them is, you know, not really liking your own appearance, you know, as far as your hair, you know, and you know, things of that nature. You know, we all know it. We all heard it a lot over time, but most of us don't know the significance of how those self-hating traits, you know, has really harmed us as a people and kept us from coming together. So keep in mind, naming is very important. We as African people, as black people, we have to start making sure we name, give our conditions specific names, so that that way they can become relevant, and then we can then deal with the issue to get to the source of why it is a problem and how it can be eradicated. Now, one thing that is going on out here, you know, with the opposition to the ADOS concept, I'd like to say is more of a battle between the introverted personalities and the extroverted personalities. You see, most of the people who are probably Pan-Africanists and who are against the ADOS concept are more than likely extroverted personalities, you know. They are the type of people who, they have a shortcoming when it comes to grasping, you know, abstract concepts so that you can understand the essence of things as to why they happen or how they happen. You know, extroverts, you know, normally because they're more people persons, you know, they latch on to concepts and arguments which are, in a sense, popular amongst people. So since, you know, many, whereas compared to introverts, now introverts always question. You know, they want to know the essence of why something is a thing. They want to know how stuff works, you know. Introverts are not so much people persons, you know, because they actually judge people, you know, by us as introverts. You know, we as introverts, we, in a sense, judge people, if you want to use that word for lack of a better word, based upon their actions, not just because, you know, they're people, or we might think they're cute, or we might think they're funny, you know. We want to see what you're really about as a person. And whereas it comes with a concept, you know, we want to see how it functions. That is why in this time, you know, in the fight against white supremacy, the ones who are really leading, you know, the charge, or who are the strongest voices, you know, against white supremacy, I think, are actually natural introverts or natural ambiverts. You know, they don't mind going in seclusion, they don't mind being left alone so they can think large and so they can think largely and think about broad concepts and bring solutions to the table. So the point I'm trying to get at is when I say that, is that extroverts, you know, play your position. Use your personality, you know, to carry the message that is put forth by introverted people who have actually proven some of the concepts that they're putting forth as concerned white supremacy. Take your natural personality and take it amongst the people. Don't just sit back, you know, and naysay and argue simply because you cannot grasp, you know, the broad nature, you know, of that concept that is being put forth. True enough, it's good to question, but once the argument has been proven to be legitimate, accept it as a truth and just don't keep on bantering with your opinion simply because you feel like you want to be right or you feel like, you know, other people are not accepting it, so I'm not going to accept it, you know. Take that extroverted personality and spread that message amongst the people so that we can begin to work effectively as a group against the same conditions under which we suffer as a people, which is white supremacy. Once again, this is Stuart Knight, author of the books Marginalizing White Supremacy, Poetic Visions, A Steep Mystic for a Sister, and my latest work, A Spirit the World Has Forgotten. Oh, and by the way, the introvert and extrovert and ambivert, you know, personality concepts that I've just theorized and put forth, you know, are in my book, A Spirit the World Has Forgotten. So if you want to read into that a little bit more to get a little bit more understanding about that, you know, go ahead and pick that ebook up. Thanks again. Peace.